Shalom and Salamta. This is Wendy Malonzo of the Line of Judah Society. And, co-laborers, co-laboring. You know, due to the recent, events that have taken place, specifically Women's Wednesdays, and some of the stuff that I and I've been observing or been witnessing, I realized that, you know, some things I personally take for granted and just assume that many have already come to the full understanding of what, you know, I and I have received from such a time. And so, although we've put out material in one particular case before, long ago, it seems that these small details that need to be brought to the conscious of us as a organization. And that's the key word, actually, to be organized and what it requires. Now, it's necessary to bring forth certain things I just assumed was ones as a fellow disciple in the society to just realize for himself and just go about it and conclude and complete and fulfill. Now, the Line of Judah Society. And I'm not saying anything negative about Women's Wednesday. I just saw that some things are just not known, even amongst others that have been, you know, in fellowship, co-laboring for such a time now. And it was pretty interesting. So now it is necessary that we bring forth in the beginning to co-laboring in the Line of Judah Society of His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie I. I personally would counsel, and I see no reason why this counsel should not be taken up and received. And for the record, this is in love. But in love, we love one another the way that Jesus Christos, Yeshua HaMashiach, hath loved us. And we do all things decently and in order, for we are an organization and we must be organized. And thus, we bring forth this message, this following message, in the beginning of co-laboring, before we even go forward to these other works, which in the grace and mercy of the Almighty, Yahweh Elohim, hath been permitted. And I, elder brother, hath not made it anything. But I personally, out of love that Jesus Christos hath showed us, in which that in turn glues us together, bound or bonded with a glue stronger than even blood, bring forth this out of the necessity to honor and to give credit where credit is due. And so for my brother Wendom Yadon, and that's redundant, so anyway, for Rasiatinos Teferi Wendom Yadon, to Aina brother Yadon, it is worthy that credit be given to whom credit is due. And the brother has worked hard and long time to set up the organization, and the least I and I could do coming into it is give honor to the system that hath already been established with blood, sweat, and tears. I and I sure. I and I. So, I would say, are we co-laboring? But first and foremost, are we even officially, in spirit and in truth, a member of the society? Have we even taken the liberty to print out an application, fill out the form, along with the $10 fee, which is another reason why I and I do this kind of thing, is because it's a good way to, you know, we can all afford $10, and it's support nonetheless for the society. You know, we've even brought forth this message to the Spanish speaking true and faithful scattered throughout the world. we've brought forth this because it's a principal step. It's the beginning. It's a society. It's an organization. If you have not applied and presented the fee required, you're not documented as even a member officially. In spirit and truth, in spirit, you know, no doubt. I ain't trying to take that from no one, but if we go apply for a job or any other kind of club or whatever, we do apply. We go through the process. So why would we disrespect the society of His Majesty that now carries that Ark of the Covenant? So I don't think it's like even a question. In love, we would all run out to do it. And it's cool if we didn't know. But now that we know, what are we to do? So are we even official members? Official members of the society, have we even applied and submitted our applications? Along with this, I would recommend to organize a binder with those plastic clear covers, you know, and in which are encased by going to lojsociety.org/study. PDF versions, it's easy, just go there and all these documents are ready for us to take it seriously. So going forward, I would suggest that the Shabbat readings be printed up and those be no doubt set aside in a different binder that is more pertaining to the discipleship, but it is still as important. As for the binder that will hold the important documents for the society as official members recognized through our application and signature and entrance fee, once recognized, recommend counsel that we go forward with this binder and also printing out the Eternal Life New Covenant Creed. Sign it if necessary. Store it within the binder. Along with the copy of the application, we send one in, we keep one. And if necessary, print out extra copies. We counsel to go forward and print out the Eternal Life of His Imperial Majesty Covenant terms. If necessary, sign, store in one of those plastic clear covers in that binder, recognized as an official member of the society. I would also counsel that the Declaration of Sovereignty be printed out, read, and studied. The Letter of Opinion be printed out, read, studied. And no doubt, the Line of Judah Society, ICC, the Universal Church Code, specifically be studied, read, and studied again. And go online, and there's videos that our brother Yadon has put forth concerning the Universal Church Code official order of Rastafari business. And I would counsel that a copy of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights as well be printed and stored within this binder of an official member of the society. Now, why the Universal Declaration of Human Rights? Because our UCC, Universal Church Code, brings forth a position that is upheld only and through the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So we would counsel to go forward in such a way. And, it's what it is. So we give thanks to all. Shalom. Salam.